Have you ever wondered what some of your favorite stars did before they made it big? Well, believe it or not, many of them started out as supermodels. We'll show you their throwback modeling photos that will make you smile, laugh, and maybe even cringe. Can you guess which four celebs used to model for the American clothing brand Abercrombie & Fitch? Stay tuned to our video to see who they are. If this is your first time visiting our channel, don't forget to subscribe and please give this video a big thumbs up. Today, we'll be showing you 10 superstars who started off as models. Robert Pattinson. Robert Pattinson achieved worldwide success when he appeared in the Twilight movie series. The hunky actor immediately became a heartthrob and stole girls' hearts all across the globe before he became internationally known as the character Edward Cullen. Robert was still trying to get his foot in the door of the entertainment industry. Did you know he actually started off as a model? And let's just say we're glad he decided to go with acting instead. It's not that he was a horrible model, it's just that we can't stop laughing at these super cheesy photos. As a teenager, Robert modeled underwear for a Chinese fashion magazine, and the photos are as cringeworthy as ever. As a matter of fact, we're sure Robert probably wishes these photos could get scrubbed from the internet forever. Here, he is doing his best impression of Tyra Banks. Smize. That's the ability to smile with your eyes, in case you didn't know. Soon after appearing in these ads, Robert moved on to pursue his acting career. After winning the role as the handsome and telepathic vampire in Twilight, the modeling industry still wanted a piece of him. He has since appeared in various ad campaigns for many luxury brands, including Christian Dior. In case he ever gets tired of acting, he could always jump back into the modeling world full-time, but we think we'd rather see him on the big screen. Jennifer Lawrence. A celebrity who many people consider to be an overnight success story is Jennifer Lawrence. When she kicked butt on the set of Hunger Games as the character Katniss Everdeen, it launched her career as one of the most sought-after stars in Hollywood. Since then, she has landed so many gigs, including roles in American Hustle and Silver Linings Playbook. But before becoming the it girl at red carpet events, she did a little bit of modeling. As a preteen, she posed for a photographer in a series of adorable pictures. Then, in 2006, she appeared in an ad for Abercrombie & Fitch. And just check her out! She was still as beautiful as ever, and we think she looks amazing in this black and white shot. We're used to seeing her all dolled up in expensive evening gowns at industry events, so it's nice to see her in this whole new light. She looks like the average girl next door, don't you agree? Even though she looks like a natural in front of the camera, modeling wasn't her true love. She always had dreams of becoming an actress, and soon enough, her dreams came true. These days, she has realized that she doesn't have to choose between acting and modeling. She can do both. When she's not on set, she's dazzling the camera in ads for Christian Dior's handbag and lipstick campaigns. Leighton Meester. While watching Leighton Meester on screen on Gossip Girl, it's really no surprise that she was once a model. Not only is she a talented actress, but she has some stunning good looks too. She's practically the total package in terms of what both the modeling and acting worlds crave. Long before she was known as the Queen Bee, aka Blair Waldorf, Leighton was a young girl who moved to New York to see if she could land a modeling gig. She was signed to Wilhelmina Models Agency soon thereafter, and she landed some pretty huge campaigns. She was featured in ads for Ralph Lauren and Clearasil. And we're not too sure what this particular ad was for, but we have to admit, Leighton looks adorable in those PJs. It's obvious this modeling world loved her, but she realized acting was her calling. When she auditioned for Gossip Girl, we're pretty sure the casting director fell in love with her beauty, but we think her experience as a model definitely helped her snag the role of Blair. The show loved Leighton because she was willing to dye her blonde hair brunette, and because she wasn't overly nice and kissing everyone's butt. She was a true professional who wowed everyone with her poise and grace. We guess those years of being a professional model really paid off. Ashton Kutcher. If you don't recognize Ashton Kutcher for his portrayal of Apple's Steve Jobs in the film Jobs, then you probably know him as Michael Kelso on the series That 70s Show. These days, Ashton is a family man who's devoted to his children and his wife, Mila Kunis. But there was a time when he was the most eligible bachelor in Hollywood. Girls just couldn't get enough of his chiseled features and his set of rock-hard abs that he loved to show off. Now that we think about it, it's really no surprise that someone as handsome as Ashton was once a model. While attending college in Iowa, he was hanging out at a restaurant when he was approached by a talent scout who invited him to compete in their modeling competition. Ashton agreed, and he actually won the grand prize trip to New York City. He eventually dropped out of college and became a full-time full-time model. But unlike others who try to break into the industry, Ashton didn't have to struggle to find gigs. One of his most popular ad campaigns is this one from Calvin Klein. Check him out as he works the camera. Just 1 year after he became a supermodel, Ashton was able to officially leave the industry behind. He auditioned for That 70s Show, and the rest is history. Channing Tatum. Remember we mentioned earlier that there were four superstars who modeled for Abercrombie and Fitch before they became famous? Well, we've already shown you pictures from Jennifer Lawrence's campaign, and now it's time to show you the second star who modeled for the brand. But before we let you see the smoking hot pictures of Channing Tatum's Abercrombie ad, we're going to tell you how he went from supermodel to superstar. As early as 2002, Channing was signed with Ford Models and was hitting the runway at New York and Milan Fashion Week. He sashayed his way down the catwalk for brands such as Sean John, Marc Ecko, and Nautica. After hitting the runway, he was interviewed by fashion critic Tim Blanks. He revealed that modeling wasn't his long-term career goal, and his ultimate desire was to become an actor. We're glad to see Channing was able to make his ultimate dream come true, but we can take a moment to appreciate some of his sultry modeling photos. He looks amazing in films, but we think he looks even better when he's staring seductively into the camera. Ooh la la! And here he is as the focal point in an Abercrombie & Fitch campaign. We're not sure what's going on in this photo, but we kind of dig it. Stay tuned to see the other stars who also worked for Abercrombie in the past. Raven-Symone. Many people don't realize Raven-Symone wasn't always a television star. When she was a toddler, she had a very successful career as a model before she became known as Raven Baxter on the Disney Channel series That's So Raven. The superstar and her family had moved from Atlanta to New York City to help pursue her modeling career. While there, she was chosen to work for the prestigious agency Ford Models. She appeared in ads for products such as Ritz Crackers, Fisher-Price, and Jell-O Pudding. Just 1 year after she moved to NYC, Raven was very close to landing her big break. She auditioned for a role in the film Ghost Dad, starring Bill Cosby. But since she was only 3 years old at the time, the filmmakers didn't think she was old enough to be in the movie. Thankfully, Raven made such an impression during her audition, Bill Cosby cast her to appear in a series, The Cosby Show. She was hired on to play the character Olivia. With her acting resume building and becoming more and more impressive throughout the years, it wasn't long before Raven caught the attention of Disney execs. The next time you watch her spin-off show, Raven's Home, just remember that although she's pretty amazing as the psychic character, acting wasn't always a priority in her life. Modeling was her bread and butter up until Hollywood came knocking. Olivia Wilde. As an actress, Olivia Wilde exudes beauty and talent. She stole the show on the award-winning program House as Dr. Remy, also known as 13. And she's well known for playing Angela Holden in the 2007 film Alpha Dog. If you've ever seen any of her work, we're sure you were probably mesmerized by just how gorgeous she appears on screen. Seriously, Olivia is stunning. And the reason why she looks like she could be on the cover of a magazine is because she actually had a pretty successful career as a model way back in the day. Early on in her career, Olivia was yet another Hollywood hopeful who was modeling for Abercrombie. She looked a lot different from what she looks like now, don't you think? While we know her for having her signature brown locks, Olivia was sporting blonde hair for Abercrombie as she posed for this beautiful shot in the back of a car. We think she could have really killed it as a supermodel based on this picture alone, but life had other things in store for her. The same year she modeled for Abercrombie, she was cast as Alex in the hit Fox series The OC, alongside actress Misha Barton. So far, we've seen three models turned actors who modeled for Abercrombie, and we still have one more to go. Keep watching to see who it is. Ian Somerhalder. To be a model doesn't mean you have to have a perfectly symmetrical face, an awesome body, and a flawless walk. These days, modeling agencies are looking for people with more unique features to be the faces of their brands. But thankfully for Ian Somerhalder, he had all the conventional good looks that brands were craving. Before he officially became a household name, Ian was just a teenage boy who was front and center in the modeling world. He wasn't working for small brands and startup businesses. Ian was landing lucrative gigs for luxury brands such as Versace, Nautica, and Guess. Even at such a young age, he had jaw-dropping good looks right down to his chiseled features and his piercing eyes. It didn't take him long to make that smooth transition from supermodel to actor as he made guest roles in hit TV shows like CSI and Law & Order. But Ian really made waves in the industry when he played the character Boone on the show Lost and Damon Salvatore on The Vampire Diaries. It has been years since he appeared in his first modeling ad, but his looks haven't changed much. If he ever gets gets some free time from his busy acting schedule, we think he would definitely pay the modeling world a visit. We could really use some more steamy photos of him, don't you agree? Emma Roberts. The fourth celebrity who received their big break as an Abercrombie model is none other than Emma Roberts. Back in 2005, when she was just 14 years old, Emma made her debut in this A&F ad. How young and innocent does she look in this shot? We love the simplicity of the photo, from her plain white tank and jeans to the minimal makeup on her face. Just looking at this picture, we could tell that even back then, Emma had so much potential. Obviously, the modeling world was already aware of how natural she was behind the camera, and it didn't take long for the entertainment industry to realize she was destined for greatness as well. By the time she appeared in this clothing campaign, she had already had small roles in TV and film projects. However, she really caught everyone's attention in the Nickelodeon series Unfabulous and the 2007 movie Nancy Drew. Since then, she has gained recognition for taking on more mature roles, including appearances in the films Palo Alto and The Black Coat's Daughter, and the television series Scream Queens. Which superstar do you think had the best Abercrombie and Fitch ad? Jennifer Lawrence, Channing Tatum, Olivia Wilde, or Emma Roberts? Don't forget to leave your answer down below in the comment section. Now, let's move on to the very last celeb on our list who went from model to superstar. Zuleika Rivera. When Luis Fonsi, Daddy Yankee, and Justin Bieber teamed up to record the song Despacito, the world fell in love with the Spanish language jam. When the video was released, it made us love the track even more. It was filmed in gorgeous Puerto Rico, with the neighborhood of La Perla as the backdrop. Although Bieber was missing from the video shoot, there was someone else who was there that caught everyone's attention. Zuleika Rivera played the lead role in the video, and she famously swiveled her hips all over Puerto Rico. People immediately began to wonder, who's this brunette bombshell? Come to find out, before she appeared in the video, Zuleika had a very long career as a fashion model and a beauty queen. This probably comes as no surprise to most people, considering she looks like she practically hit the genetic lottery. Her good looks, elegant sense of style, and her ability to wow the judges earned her the title of Miss Puerto Rico Universe in 2006. That same year, she also took home the crown as Miss Universe. When she wasn't training for pageants, she walked the catwalk for various top designers, and she even snagged a deal to model for CoverGirl beauty brand when she was in her early 20s. Now that she is known as the Despacito girl, so many doors are opening up for her. She has launched a clothing line, a fragrance collection, and even a swimsuit line. Thanks for watching this video, and we hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to check out our friends at The Trendy to see more cool videos for teenagers.